But yet things can be so bad that that's more enjoyable to you and to your heart than living. Let me ask you, do you think that's really going to end everything? Do you think that you're going to just die and it's over? No. That's not the end. What's going to happen is, it's going to be like you closed your eyes, went to sleep, suddenly woke up. Have you ever gone to sleep? You're so tired, and then there's a noise, you wake up and it's morning. It's like that. You're going to blink. And what are you going to see? What are you going to hear? What is going to be happening? Well, the Bible says, Revelation 7:1, that Jesus is coming back, and every eye will see him, even those that killed him. So that man is going to see Jesus coming. The question is he going to be happy? Is he going to say, "Lo, this is my God, I have waited for him"? Is he going to be happy? Or is he going to hide from the face of Jesus? In fact, people, everybody is going to see Jesus coming. Everybody from the beginning, even Adam and Eve and Noah and all the people. But his coming is going to be so bright and so amazing that those that are not ready are going to die again because they can't handle it. Now, as Seventh-day Adventists, I know many of you know these things, right? We're going to be in heaven for 1,000 years, then they're going to be raised from the dead again. But that's not the topic today. I just wanted to let you know that I know that there are problems in everyone's life, just like they are in my life. And, you know, the man that jumped was Chinese, and he was wealthy. He had nice clothes. He was living in a nice place. Do nice things and money bring happiness? No. Romans 8:28 is a beautiful verse. How many of you know what that verse says? All things work together for good to them who love God. So when we understand that there is a sickness, there is a birth, there are things happening in our life we are not sure how to handle, we can look to that verse and we can say, if we love God, if we love God, what is it, brother? If we love God, we don't have to worry because everything will work together for good. Now, I'm going to share with you a story. I was hoping, you know, and I'll just say this, I'll insert this for the young people. The reason to get married is so that you can really enlarge your, or expand your efforts for the Lord, right? So you can do more for the Lord. My wife and I were in Thailand recently, and we had a miracle story there. I'm not going to ask her to come up and interpret or tell it, but in the future, I hope that she will join me up here and we'll be preaching together. She'll be preaching. In fact, I would love to be able to preach in Tagalog and Saya fluently. That's one of my passions. Well, we had an experience. I brought everything that I needed for ministry on this trip. I mean, I brought an entire office, like the printers, the computers, everything for an office, everything for a recording studio, from the mixers to digital to sound system, speaker, and all good quality stuff, mostly Japanese, but they're great quality, and, you know, and German. And so I had this stuff with me, and I cannot part with it. It's just, it's got to get to the Philippines. But when we got to the airlines, he said, 28,000 baht. That's over 50,000 pesos extra fee for the luggage. I started trying all my credit cards, and nothing would go through because it's such a big amount. The companies think it's fraud, and you know, and they need to board the airplane. We need to board them. They need to board the airplane. And so, I have had an experience, and I have enough time and years in my life. I knew God was going to give us the miracle, and I was just excited. I thought, this is God's stuff. This isn't about me. This is about Him. If He doesn't want us to bring it, maybe we should go and leave it here. But I started thinking, we have books, we have special things in there for children and for family. You know, I don't think God wants us to just leave it here and be destroyed. They have in the airport, unattended baggages will be confiscated and destroyed. Have you heard that in the airport? You can't leave your bags, you know, because you're a criminal, so you can't leave them. They think it's a bomb, or they think it's something bad, or maybe drugs, but no, it was just good things, and we needed to get it on the plane. So I told my wife, I tried many airlines, and I'm watching the clock. And a lot of times God works at the last second. Do you notice that? He wants to test our faith and see if we are truly trusting Him. We pray for a miracle,